Hello children, welcome to EVS class. We have completed chapter 6, Every Drop Counts. And in that chapter, you have learned the water scarcity in Rajasthan and techniques and skills used by people to conserve water there. And this chapter, chapter 7, is also related with water. And you have already learned so many things about water, like uses of water, properties of water, sources of water, different forms of water. And the last year in fourth standard, you did an activity to find out what all things can dissolve in water and what all things do not dissolve in water. Do you remember that? Yes. So in our day-to-day life, we come across with many experiments. For example, your mother does experiment in the kitchen. When she makes a new thing, new food item, it is an experiment. Your father does experiment with some machines. For example, if your fan is not working or if your mixer is not working, he may open it and find out what is wrong with him. And that is a kind of experiment. And you also do many experiments daily. For example, if your toy is broken and you will try to put them together somehow. And or you will try to fix them. It is a kind of experiment. And those who are very talented in drawing, they will try different color combination for their paintings. It is a kind of experiment. So knowingly or unknowingly, we come across different types of experiments in our life. Okay. And so the learning intention of this lesson is to be able to know about the experiments with water which are related to our daily life. Okay, then let me introduce the keywords first. Yes, the title of the lesson is Experiments with Water. Keywords. Here comes the keywords. Float. Float means what? To rest or remain on the surface of a liquid. You can see a tube is floating on water here. And sink. Sink means go down to the bottom of a liquid. Sink. A stone. You can see a stone sinking in water. An iron nail. You know what is an iron nail? Aluminium foil. Aluminium foil is mostly used to wrap food items. Aluminium foil. Dead Sea. Dead Sea, actually, it is not a sea, it is a lake. Salty lake. Dead Sea is a, I will show you some images of Dead Sea. It's a salt lake in Asia, which lies between Israel and Jordan. And no life is possible in Dead Sea. See this, because the water is too salty, so no animals and plants can survive in this water. And interestingly, even if a person doesn't know how to swim, he or she wouldn't drown in this sea. They will remain on the top surface of water. They float on water. Dandi March. Dandi March. This is a historical event happened in India in 1930 before independence. See this. I'll show you some images related to Dandi March. And Dandi March, it is also known as Salt Satyagraha. It was the famous movement launched by Gandhiji to break salt law. As the British government imposed a tax on the salt, and Gandhiji decided to break the law. And so he walked for 24 days. He started his journey from 12th March to 6th April. And that journey ended on, that walk ended on 6th April. And he walked for 24 days with his trusted volunteers from Ramadi Ashram to Dandi. And they had broken the law by making salt at Dandi. And this incident took place in 1930. Gujarat, you know, Gujarat is one of the western states in India. Gandhiji was born in Porbandar in Gujarat. Capital of Gujarat is Gandhinagar. evaporation. Evaporation means that is the process of turning from liquid state to gaseous state. Evaporation. Dissolve means get mixed with, dissolve. Get mixed in some water or some liquid, dissolve. Density. Density, new term for you. Density means it's a measure of mass per volume. What is mass? Mass means quantity of matter in an object. And in everyday life, mass is called weight actually. But mass and weight are not same. Because weight of an object changes according to gravity. Gravity means gravitational force. Earth has a force of attraction that is called gravitational force. Earth attracts everything towards its center. That is why when we throw something upward, it comes down. Because it won't go upwards because of the force of attraction of Earth. That is called gravitational force. So, if you go to space, if you check your weight, the reading will be zero. Understand? But the mass will be same. But weight may change according to the gravitational force. Because on the space, there is no gravitational force. Okay. And volume means amount of space of the object that the object takes up. Or in simple way, we can say it is the size of object or the amount of space needed by the object. That is volume. So density means mass per volume. Heavier objects have high density. Lighter objects have low density. Okay. So now we have seen the keywords of this lesson. Now let me talk about the success criteria. First success criteria is that to know that some things float on water whereas some things sink in water. Okay, have you ever thought that why do some things float on water and why do some things sink in water? Okay, I have collected some things for you. I'm going to put them one by one in this. I have a bowl, plastic bowl. I have taken a plastic bowl with water and I have collected some things here. And I'm going to put one by one in this and check whether they will float or sink. Okay, see, this is a plastic bowl. Okay, let us see what happens. Yes, you can see that ball floats on water. It's not sinking, it floats on water. Yes. Now another one. See, now I have a pebble, stone, small piece of stone or pebble. See what happens? Yes, it sank in water. That pebble or the stone sank in water. See, because this is heavier. Understand, this is denser than this water. Ball is lighter than this water. And now I have a rubber band. Okay. I don't know whether you can see or not. Now it is floating. Rubber band is floating in this water because rubber band is lighter in weight, has less density. Rubber band. Now I have a key. See this key? I'm going to put this key in this water. Yes, it sank in water. The key sank. But it means that the key is heavier, it's more denser than water. And now I have a matchstick. See matchstick. Yes, matchstick is floating. It is floating in water. It is not sinking. Floating in water. Yes. Lighter object. Now I have a coin. See what happens. Yes, it sank in water. The coin sank in water. Coin is heavier. It's more denser than water. So now we have seen that some things float on water and something sink in water. Why do some things float on water and something sink in water? Because every object displaces water equal to its volume. Volume means that the amount of space needed for an object. That is for the size of an object. So every object displaces water equal to its Yeah. And if the displaced water is more than the weight of the object, then it will float in water. If the displaced water, see this stone, sorry, this ball. Okay, when I put this, see here the displaced water is more than the weight of this ball. That is why it is floating. See this rubber band here, when I put this inside in the water, the displaced water is more than the weight of this rubber band. That is why it is floating. Understand? And when I put this matchstick here, the displaced means to move out of the usual place, to move out of the usual place, that is remove, or to move, replace, to move out of the usual place, that is displaced. So here the displaced water is more than the weight of this matchstick. That is why it is floating. Now, in the case of this key, the key, we have seen that the key sank in water because the displaced water displaced by this key is less than the weight of the water. Or this is a stone pebble, here it sank because the water displaced by this stone or pebble is less than the weight of this stone. Okay, so this is heavier or denser. So we can conclude that everything displaces water equal to its volume. And if the displaced water is more than the weight of the object, that will float. Or if the displaced water is less than the weight of the object, that thing will sink in water. Okay. Or in short, in simple way, we can say that heavier objects have high density. Heavier objects have high density. So density, what is density? Density is mass per volume. Mass means what? What is mass? Mass means the amount of matter in an object. Mass means amount of matter in object. Volume means the amount of space needed by an object, or the size of the object. Understand? So heavier things have high density, whereas lighter things have low density. So heavier things sink in water, lighter things float in water. Now you may be thinking that if heavier things sink in water, why do this ships and boats do not sink? Is that the right question? No? Yes. See, let me say that all the things, all the objects that float must contain some trapped air inside. And this ship, of course, it's very big, but they contain trapped air inside it. Why this ball floats on water? Because there is air inside this ball, isn't it? So like that, this boat or ship also contains air inside. If we put a leaf on water, it will also float because there are spaces or air between the cells of leaves. Small spaces are there in between the cells of leaf. That is why it floats on water. So what kind of things float? How can we conclude? That is, every object displaces water equal to its volume. Okay. If the displaced water is more than the weight of the object, that object will float on water. And if the displaced water is less than the weight of the object, that will sink in water. Or in another word, we can say, in simple way, we can say that heavier objects have high density, and high denser things will sink in water. And lighter objects have low density, and low density things will float on water. Understand? See, when I put this rubber band, floated, no? Floated. It is floating because the density of this rubber band is less than the density of water, or the density of this matchstick is less than the density of this water. That is why it is floating. Understood? Now see, I have taken some water in a glass and I'm going to put a lemon. Okay, now let us see whether it will sink or float. What happens? Yes, it sank in water. The lemon sank in water. Now I am going to add some salt in this. Okay, and see what happens. I'm going to add some salt. So what happens? Yes. Yes. What happened now? See this, children? Now the lemon rises up. Now the lemon started to float in water. See? See this? Why this happened, you know? That is, in beginning, when lemon was in the plain water, the density of lemon is more than the density of water. Now when I added salt in this water, density of water became more than the density of lemon. Lemon became less denser than water. Understand? When I put lemon in plain water, it was sinking. You saw it sinking in the water, because there that time density of lemon was more than that of density of water. Okay, now when I added salt in this water, and here the density of water became more than that of this lemon. Density of lemon decreased here. Understand? So, in this way, we can say that density decides whether things float or sink in water. Now, let me talk about another thing, Dead Sea. I have shown you the picture of Dead Sea. And what is interesting about Dead Sea, actually, Dead Sea is not a sea. It is a lake that lies, it is in Asia, which lies between Israel and Jordan. And no life is possible in Dead Sea, because the water is too salty. Understand? So, yeah, and interestingly, even if a person does not know how to swim, he or she would not drown. They will float on this water. And Dead Sea has so many health benefits also, because the mud of this Dead Sea carries potassium and calcium, and which is needed for our skin to stay young and healthy. Understand? And there also, the density of the water is too much. That is why we can float on that Dead Sea. Understand? So, how do things float on water? That is, if the displaced water is more than the weight of the object, then that thing will float. Or if it is lighter in weight and has less density, that things will float on water. And if the displaced water is less than the weight of the object, then that thing will sink in water. Or heavier objects with high density will sink in water. Okay? So let's wind up this session here. I hope you all understood this. Watch this video many times. Read the textbook also. And see you in the next session. Okay, take care. Bye.